Good afternoon, everyone. My name is M. Vijay Kumar. I'm working as an assistant professor in the Department of Civil Engineering. Today I'm going to give a lecture on foundation engineering. So this is the foundation engineering. So first we need to now discuss what do we mean by foundation. Then we go for different types of foundations and what is the importance of the foundation. Nowadays what kind of foundations are going. These kind of things we have to study this session. So first basically the foundation, everybody they are going to study in previous session, previous year they are already studying in geotechnical engineering. Now they are going to study foundation engineering. So before I'm going to discuss what do you mean by foundation. So why we need to study foundations, what is the importance, so that we need to study today in this session. So foundation is nothing but lowest part of superstructure. So what do you mean by lowest part of the superstructure? So what is a substructure? So based on these two things, then we go for definition of the foundation. So now I'll draw a diagram. So simply, so based on this diagram, then we can classify as whether structure is superstructure or substructure. Then we can classify easily. So this is a load can be denoted by kilonewton. So these are the original ground levels. So these are the original ground levels. So this is can be called as a footing. So this is footing. So these are the columns. Columns. So now we are giving the load. So these are the ground level. So here these are the columns. So bottom below footings. So this can be filled by entire below ground level. We have some different types of materials. So we already studied in geotechnical engineering. Now also I can recall everything in the geotechnical. Then we go for foundation engineering. So these are the soils. So here, so first we need to discuss. So what do you mean by substructure? What do you mean by superstructure? So the foundation engineering, the definition is nothing but lowest part of the superstructure. So here, we will classify as these things. So everybody in every structural people, they have to design superstructure only. So those who are coming geotechnical and foundation engineering people, that they will discuss substructure only. So what is the importance of the substructure and superstructure? If you suppose nowadays many consultancies people they are working under the low ground level only, that we call as a substructure. So why it is very very important? So why we need to study the substructure? So because we are giving more loads. Suppose we are giving 2 tons, 3 tons based on the requirement, people requirement. So based on the client requirements, we are going to give the loads to 2,000, 4,000. So many tons loads we are giving nowadays. So based on that one, so here when we are giving the loads, whether the particular soil, so below we have substructure, in the below that soil, whether it is black or any type of soil, whether it is sand or clay or silt, thus that soil, whenever we are giving 2 kilometers, 4 kilometers, otherwise 2 tons, 4 tons, that soil, whether it is capable or not, whether it is bearing or not, that we have to test it. So that kind of work will be done by the geotechnical engineering people only. That's why many consultancies nowadays they are doing so below ground level only. So that means subsoil exploration, soil investigation report they have to submit to the particular client. So that is the reason. Suppose we are going to, this is the residential building. So we are giving that, we are going to design residential building. So here, what kind of soil? So what kind of columns we have to design, what is the depth of footing that we have to calculate it. So in the structural people they have to design above the ground level, that means superstructure. They will design only whether it is beams or columns. Okay. So beams or columns, otherwise T beams, L beams, T section, I section, any kind of design they will use structural people only. So below ground level, if anything happened, whether it is settlement will occur, otherwise collapse or anything causes, that responsibility we have to take the geotechnical people only. Because when you are giving the below ground level, the structure is, otherwise the footing is very strong, the structure will be very safe in future also. So nowadays in 2005 in Hyderabad, Punjab Gutta flyover collapsed. Suddenly fallen because these reasons only. So what kind of reasons the Punjab Gutta flyover fall down? So I will tell you what is the exact reasons. So that is the reason. So we have to study in that particular, we are going to design foundation. So as of you know, everybody they got clarity about that superstructure, substructure. So about the this ground level, that we call as a superstructure. So up to this mark, thus we call it as a substructure. So what is the need for substructure and superstructure? What is the difference? So when you are going to structural people, they have to design above the ground level. Like even if you see these buildings also, above the ground level, this we call as a superstructure. So below ground level, if you go 2 meters, 3 meters, that we call as a substructure. So every geotechnical people or foundation people, they have to focus on below the ground level. Okay. In the below ground level, so we have soil. So in the soil, if you see, soil is nothing but, so as per geotechnical engineering, according to Carl Lattice, is the father of soil mechanics. So based on father of soil mechanics, Carl Lattice, soil is nothing but naturally occurring unconsolidated surface of the earth material. So why it is saying naturally occurring unconsolidated? So before we are going to discuss the soil definition, so just now I discussed soil is nothing but naturally occurring unconsolidated surface of the earth material. So you see, this is the material, so we have below ground level, below soil. So soil is nothing but, so according to Carl Lattice is telling, soil is nothing but naturally, it is not artificial, we are not preparing, it is already, it is formed naturally. So naturally occurring unconsolidated. So unconsolidated, that means now we will discuss unconsolidated soils, unconsolidated material. So unconsolidated nothing but, so loose material. So in this loose material, naturally occurring unconsolidated nothing but loose material. So it is a loose state. So in this loose material, so when you are using this foundation purpose, okay, the soil is not good condition. So it is not capable to bear 1-2 ton load. So this time what we have to do? So this is our my question. So just we are discussing basically the soil is nothing but unconsolidated. The naturally material is loose material. So this material we are going to use construction purpose, like if we take a residential building. So okay, residential building. So suppose we are using this pipe. So here we are giving 2 newtons load. So this is the load we are giving 2 tons. This. So what are the loads we are giving directly? Transmitted to the soil only. What are the loads we are giving? Suppose if you are standing here, that load it is taken by the soil only, ground level only. That load, so when you are giving 2 ton loads, if it is not capable to bear that much of load, so what we have to do it at the time? So that we need to study ground improvement techniques. So we have important subject, ground improvement techniques. So this is a very very important. So when you are going to discuss the below ground level, so ground improvement techniques, it's very very important. So this soil is not good condition to bear this 2 ton. So that we have to improve this soil. So we are going to improve this soil. We have not, when you are going to improve that soil, that we call as a soil stabilization. So soil stabilization, see, stabilization is nothing but strengthening of the soil. So when you are going to strengthening of the soil, that soil will be improve the strength. So strengthening of the soil nothing but increase the shear strength. Okay, increase the shear strength and decrease the permeability and decrease the compressibility. So when you are decreasing permeability, when you are decreasing compressibility, so then the strength is automatically increases. Okay, when the shear strength is high, the structure will be safe. So what kind of procedures, what kind of technology we have to adapt, already adapted. Okay, that we have to study. So soil stabilization is nothing but improvement, strengthening of the soil. So we have some different types of techniques. So what are the different types of techniques? So one is lime stabilization. So lime stabilization is one of the techniques for improving the less bearing capacity soils. So another one is bitumen stabilization. So bitumen stabilization. So lime stabilization, bitumen stabilization. Next, geosynthetics. So next, geosynthetics. Next, so after geosynthetics, lime stabilization, bitumen stabilization. Next, with the help of fly ash. So it is made from the some industrial coal mines. You will get the mine areas will get fly ash. This is also waste material. So with the help of GZPS, ground granular furnace blast. So ground granular blast furnace slab with the help of the GZPS also. So we can improve the this low bearing capacity soils. So we are discussing all the things. So which soil is low bearing capacity soils? So when it is loose means less bearing capacity. So what kind of soils? So that we have to discuss now. So now we have to discuss. So next, I'm going to discuss about low bearing capacity soils. So at which condition the soil will be less bearing capacity? So we have lot of formulas, lot of methods to improve the less bearing capacity soils. So if we take the BC soil, so it is nothing but so black bottom soil. So nowadays this type of soil we are using in crop soils. Nothing but this is very useful for sugar cane. So nowadays what happened? So we are using a lot of lands. So many lands we are using for the construction purpose. So what are the crops is there? The cultivation of the crops. So we are cutting. Okay. So we are doing them in the particular location. We are doing foundations. We are going to design the structures. At the time, see, this is the when the taking the black part of soil. So we remove the entire crops. So we are going to design the structure. So at the beginning of structure there is no problem, we can safely we can design. So when it will start the problem? So once the rainy season, so once the rainy season starts, then problem will start. What is the relation between rainy season and soil? See, I'll tell you. Suppose the black part of the soil, it will absorb more amount of water. It will absorb huge amount of water. So after absorbing the entire amount of water, the soil will behave like a bulk. Bulk. I'll tell you one example. Even example, take it as an example. So in our body also. So when it is the body, in our body, either wells, otherwise in water. So after 24 hours, it will comes bulking state. Even the soil also it will behaves like a bulking. So that bulking nature can calculate it. So that bulking nature, technically, you know, geotechnical or foundation the point of view, expansive nature. Swell potential, expansive nature. With the help of differential free swell index test, we can calculate this bulking nature of this particular BC soils, black cancer. So these soils are highly swelling and shrinkage. Swelling and shrinkage. highly selenous sinks, these kind of soils in a particular locations, we can't go for design. So these soils risk purely for crops only. So but nowadays the demand of lands, demand of the construction, then we are going to use this type of soils. So this is the reason. Now these ones, after coming the rainy season, these soils will be absorbed more amount of water, more and more amount of water. It will start shrinkage and swelling. So after shrinkage and swelling, what will happen? Structure will be slowly settled down. So that settlement also we studied in geotechnical engineering. So initial settlement or initial consolidation. So this we call as a initial consolidation rates. So price of consolidation max, secondary consolidation. So primary consolidation or initial consolidation or initial settlement, secondary primary consolidation, primary settlement, secondary consolidation or secondary settlement. So what will happen, these settlements or these consolidation every stage, you have three stages: initial, primary and secondary. So see, before I going to discuss this initial, primary, secondary, so we have to discuss these things. So we have to discuss consolidation. So consolidation is nothing but so removal of water, okay, removal of water from soil mass under static loading condition, long term static loading condition. So here removal of water or escaping of water, removal or escaping or expulsion from soil sample. So this one, we are going to expulsion or removal or escaping of water is nothing but consolidation. So consolidation is nothing but removal or escaping or expulsion of from the soil mass under long term static loading condition. Thank you for everyone watching this video.